Several major wildfires raging across Colorado right now. They're scorching land near Rocky Mountain National Park. The Cameron Peak and East Troublesome fires, now the two largest wildfires in Colorado history, and they're burning less than 10 miles apart. The U.S. Forest Service reports the two fires have ripped through more than 375,000 acres, roughly the size of half the size of the state of Rhode Island. The fires damaging homes and destroying property, this from Grand Lake, about two-hour drive northwest of Denver. A local sheriff says some people are missing. No word on how many. Hundreds of people forced to evacuate this town as fires bear down on communities all about. You can see the smoke staining the skies a hazy orange. KUSA's Steve Steger is live in Granby, Colorado, near where the East Troublesome fire is burning out of control. Steve?
Yeah, Shep, we're here in Granby, which is just west of Rocky Mountain National Park, a town that has been under a pre-evacuation order for the last 2 days, just telling folks to be ready to get out, and a town that has had a thick blanket of smoke over it all day today. This fire that is impacting the town, the East Troublesome Fire, was originally about 25,000 acres on Wednesday. It then exploded overnight Wednesday into Thursday. It grew by about 156 square miles, the size of the city of Denver overnight. Now, it's unclear. We know there is damage, but we don't know how much because they are having trouble getting into towns that have been impacted by this. The town of Grand Lake, which is just west of Rocky Mountain National Park, has been evacuated for a while now. They are trying to get in to see how much damage there is. They're not sure. The problem with the evacuations, the sheriff telling us today, they've had an issue because some people are not heeding those evacuations. He told us about that today.
If you're going to stay up in that area, please stay inside your house. People that are roaming around on the interior of our evacuation areas are tasking my resources right now because we're having to contact those people and put our focuses on them rather than protecting some other structures and getting this repopulation area going again.
Now, the weather has helped a bit. The winds have slowed down a bit today. A little bit more humidity has helped fight this fire. Tomorrow could be another active day of fire, and then Shep, firefighters might get some help on Sunday when we expect snow.
Hope so. Steve, thanks. Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.